We're back. I'm Mike This. I'm your host, Todd Grisham. 1-888-LIVE-WWE, the number to call if you want to chat. Also, we've got the laptop kick in the chat room on WWE.com. Miss Heather from Canada says, Todd, what's up? You do a great job. Thank you. Chain Gang First Lady wants to know if I'll be giving away any prizes tonight. And the question to your, the answer to your question is yes, we will. We've got a trivia question, and it's about Randy Orton. So if you think you know enough about the Legend Killer, make sure and listen, because later on, I'm going to give you a trivia question. If you call in with the correct answer, we're going to give you an autographed DVD by Bret Hart. Let do. Maybe something from Randy Orton. Maybe I'll sign something and won't send it to you, because God knows you don't want it. Anyway, a lot of good questions here for Randy Orton, so why don't we get to them, and some callers as well. Right now, without further ado, you hear the music, you know the man. He is the Legend Killer. He will face off against The Undertaker at Armageddon in Hell in a Cell in 2 weeks. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Randy Orton. Randy, how you doing?
Mr. Grisham, thank you very much. Thank you.
That was that a big enough entrance for you?
It was wonderful, man. I appreciate it very much, Todd. Thank you.
Well, first things first, last week you were scheduled to be a guest on the show, but you, I guess, bailed out at the last minute, said you were going to do your talking that Friday night on SmackDown. What were you talking about there?
Well, Todd, you know, it's just, it's kind of hard for me right now. And by that, I mean, you know, right now, it's just there's so many things going on in my head. As far as what I was talking about, you know, it's, I think it's quite obvious. You know, I thought I had ended, you know, something. I thought I had put the legacy to an end, the Undertaker's legacy. I thought, you know, he was gone. And as we all found out, you know, from what I understand, he's not. And it shook me up. It's just not fair, Todd.
Well, I mean, not fair.
Listen to me, though. You know, I'm not done. Please. It's not fair. You know, I challenged him at WrestleMania. You know, I got him to take me on at WrestleMania, you know, and due to an injury, you know, that he capitalized on for the win, you know, it caused me to be defeated that day, you know. And then that was okay with me. You know, I'd called the big man out. I'd called the dead man out, you know, and you know, maybe that was my first mistake, but you know, damn it, I love this business, and you know, it's just not fair. You know, I didn't want all of this. You know, this is just, I'm not saying I'm not ready for this, but I deserve something else. I deserve Batista. I deserve a world title match, not a Hell in a Cell match. I mean, look, I haven't even reached my prime yet, and look what I've accomplished, Todd. I have so much more to accomplish. Why a Hell in a Cell match now? You know, why does The Undertaker, you know, and it baffles me, you know, after what happened in Cincinnati, it baffles me. And I know I'm rambling, but I just don't know what I'm going to do. You know, I need to get him to see the light of day. I need him to understand, you know, without any physicality, I need him to understand where I'm coming from. I respect him, you know, unlike anyone else, you know, and I mean that, but it's, you know, what I did to him, you know, I felt I had to do, and it's just not fair. Him coming back is not fair. A Hell in a Cell is not fair. And that's it. That's it, man.
Well, it's obvious why you're a little shaken. I mean, anybody who has The Undertaker on their heels certainly would feel that way, too. I'm rambling just thinking about it.
Todd,
anyway,
Todd, I've slapped him in the face. At the contract signing before WrestleMania, I slapped him in the face. Who all has done that? Who's done that? Let me know right now. You know, I know he's had great battles. I know he's been defeated, you know, very, very few, many times. And the odds weren't in the, you know, his favor. It was always something had to happen. You know, I took him on by myself. I burned him alive. I put him through that stage. I crashed that lowrider through that stage, and he's gone. I'm haunted. I don't know, Todd. But I do know this. I've slapped him in the face, and I've looked him in the eyes before from very, very close distance, and I know that he's got some wrath. I know he's got that rage, but I didn't think he could survive what I did to him, and he did. Well, and now I got to pay for it, but I'm going to be a man about it. But I just, you know, it's just not fair, man. It's just not fair.
Well, Randy, if you don't mind, we're going to take a couple phone calls. Is that all right? We got a lot of callers wanting to ask you some questions.
That's why I'm on the air, man.
Let's all right. Right now, let's go to line four. Lloyd, you're on with the Legend Killer.
Yes. Randy, I have to ask you, man, what were you thinking last Friday when the Undertaker challenged you to the Hell in a Cell? That is his playground. That is his domain, his yard. I mean, Lloyd, what are you thinking now?
Well, I'll tell you what, Lloyd, here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking you have no clue what it's like to be me. You're watching from the outside. You think you know this business. You might be one of those people on the internet that's reading all these rumors and these dirt sheets, and you think you know what's going on, but you don't. I'm shook. I think I displayed that last week, but I'll tell you this right now. I am the Legend Killer. I have beaten the Undertaker, and I don't need any help. I don't need my father's help. He's simply there because he's my father. He wants to be there. It's special for him to be out there, but I do this by myself. And what was I thinking? Yeah, I was shook. It's the Undertaker. He's done more than anyone in the WWE. But like I said to Todd earlier, I slapped him in the face before. I've been up close and personal with the Undertaker, and I beat him. And I can do it again. It's just, you know, the Hell in a Cell match is just, you know, historically one of the most brutal, you know, battlefields in this business's history. And I just, it's not something that I was thinking about. It's not in my mind. The Hell in a Cell is not in my mind. The World Championship is on my mind. And that's all I got to say, Lloyd. Thanks for the call.
All right, we've got Brian on line three. Brian, you're on with the Legend Killer.
Hey, Randy, what's up? I'm a big fan.
Yeah, Brian, thank you.
How are you preparing for the Hell in a Cell, and how great did it feel to shine at Survivor Series all by yourself on the stage again?
Well, you know, Survivor Series, you know, to answer that question, it was, you know, my third year in a row winning that Survivor Series style match, you know, being the sole survivor. And you know, I've done a lot of things in my career, and that's one of the things that, you know, remains closest to my heart. You know, beating Shawn Michaels, two out of those 3 years, you know, that's a big accomplishment. But going into that match, you know, my head was clear. The Undertaker was gone. You know, he was not in my mind, and now I'm a completely different person. I celebrated for that match. I celebrated after that match with that win. Only about 2 minutes. I was hoisted up on the guy's shoulders. You know, the rest of the roster, a good amount of them came down to celebrate with me. And, you know, I didn't get to celebrate too long. You know, that's the night that I found out Undertaker was still here. And when that casket was on fire, you know, you wouldn't even understand.
Well, Randy, I mean, what kind of game plan are you going to have going into Hell in a Cell? I mean, the Hell in a Cell match involving The Undertaker that first comes to mind is when he faced off against Mankind and literally nearly killed him.
Well, to prepare, Todd, I actually have done just that. I've watched several Hell in a Cell matches. Of course, I've seen them all, but I've been overloading my brain with these matches, and I think that's kind of playing into part of why I'm losing so much sleep. This last week's been brutal, man. You know, I think these images of Mick Foley flying off that cage onto that announcing table, falling through the cage onto the tacks with that chair breaking his face, breaking his jaw. It's just, you know, there's a lot of things can happen. There's a lot of elements in that cage that you cannot control. You can just not control them. When I'm in the ring, I have this confidence about me. You know, some call it arrogance, but it's not. I'm confident in what I can do in the ring. But when you put that cage around that ring and you're trapped in that cell, it's just, it's got to be different. I've been in Elimination Chamber matches. I've been in cage matches. But there's just something about that cell that, It's creepy, man. I can't explain it.
Well, I'm sure a lot of people have followed your career, and they think, boy, wouldn't it be great to be Randy Orton? I'd love to have the bright lights and all the fans screaming for me, but I doubt there are very few people right now that want to be Randy Orton as you head into Armageddon.
You know, like I was saying to the first caller, you know, these people, these fans, you know, I appreciate that they love this business, but they have no idea how much I love this business, how much I give to this business. They have no idea what's going on in my head, and it's no use telling them, Todd. It's, you know, these calls are just to humor a few people, you know, and do what I have to do for the company. But in reality, I cannot even begin to shed any light on what's going on in my head right now. It's just, it's an unbelievable feeling. You know, the match I had with Mick Foley last year at Backlash, the hardcore match that I won, that just stands in my mind. Landed on those tacks and just the blood and the barbed wire, you know, that just, it sticks, man. And it's almost as if just as that I got that out of my head, you know, this happens. And I just, You know, I'm going to be prepared, though. One way or another, I will be prepared. You know, I am a man. I'm the Legend Killer. No one knows what it's like to be Randy Orton.
Well, I remember Randy actually flew with you on the same plane the night after you faced Mick Foley and beat him in that match where you had tacks all over your body, and you really looked like you got run over by a train. But you came out on top, and hopefully good luck to you. Maybe you can do the same to Undertaker at Armageddon. We're going to take two more quick phone calls, Randy, and we'll let you go. Let's jump to Wayne from South Carolina. Wayne, you're on with the Randy Orton.
I am?
Yep, you are.
Okay.
Hello, Wayne. Hello, Wayne.
Hi. I want to know, why are you trying to destroy The Undertaker?
It's like this. It's simple, Wayne. How old are you, by the way?
We lost Wayne, but I'm guessing 12.
We lost. Yeah, he sounded rather young.
Yeah.
I don't think he should be watching the
Hell in a Cell
match for a child that young. I don't know if it's what his parents are thinking. But nonetheless, it's pretty simple, Todd. I mean, everyone knows, I was pretty sure, why I'm going after The Undertaker. I've said it before on television, met numerous times. I'm the Legend Killer. That's why I'm going after him. I end legacies. I kill legends. I defeat them. I disgrace them. I embarrass them. I embarrass them in the middle of the ring. I was born, I was raised to do this for a living. It's my passion. It's my love. Being in the ring is what I do best. And The Undertaker was the biggest dog in the yard, like you said many times before. And it's time to put that dog down. It was my time. It was his time to go down. I had a slight mishap in WrestleMania, a slight mishap. I would slip my shoulder out of socket when I picked him up to give him his own tombstone pile driver, and things didn't work out the way I had planned. But I'm going to finish business at Hell in a Cell. I'm a man of my word. I'm the Legend Killer, and I'm going to finish business at Hell in a Cell.
All right, Pete from California, you're on with Randy Orton.
Hey, Randy.
Yeah, Pete.
All right, you know, my question, I'm wondering, maybe I may have jumped the gun with this one, but if you do indeed defeat The Undertaker in Hell in a Cell, which in my opinion doesn't look like it's going to happen, but if it does...
Well, thank you, Petey.
Get to the question, Pete.
Yes, for us.
If it does happen, after The Undertaker, who's next? What legend are you going to slay?
Well, I don't think Batista's a legend, but his name's on the list next. I think that's an obvious answer to your question.
And Randy, I mean, you know Batista as well as anybody, having been in Evolution with him for so long. Not to look ahead, but what kind of match would we see if you and Dave Batista got in the ring together?
I'm pretty confident as far as the outcome with Batista. You're right, I was in an Evolution with him. You know, we were taught by the same Triple H and Ric Flair, two of the best in this business, you know, all around, you know, and, you know, my hat's off to both of them. I respect both of them greatly, and mainly, you know, not for their personal, you know, it wasn't a friendship there at all. But what I've learned from those men has carried me on, you know, that, and from what I've learned from my father to where I am now. And Batista, just, he was a slow learner. From the beginning, he was a slow learner. Sure, he's big, he's powerful, he's a monster. You know, when he gets that adrenaline rush, you know, look out. You know, I know his strengths, but I know his weaknesses. And that's all I got to say. You know?
All right. Randy Orton, thanks for calling in to Bite This. Good luck this week on Friday Night SmackDown, and super good luck at Armageddon as you go to Hell in a Cell with The Undertaker.
Thank you, Todd. Thanks for the interview.
All right. There you have it. If he hits the RKO, we could be looking at the end of The Undertaker for good. What do you think? Could happen. All right. Hey, when we come back, P.S. Michael Hayes, the fabulous Freebird, will be on live. And trust me, when this man's got a live microphone on, you never know what he's going to say. You don't want to miss it. We're taking your calls. 888-LIVE-WWE. I'm Todd Grisham. This is Bite This.